Okay, so let's now show an example of a hyperbolic cylinder. So we know this is going to be a hyperbolic cylinder because, yeah, there's a third variable missing, the z, okay? This is a hyperbola on the xy plane. There's that minus sign, okay? That's how you will distinguish it from the elliptical cylinder because the ellipse has a plus, okay? There. All right, and also because y squared is the one that's positive, so that means this cylinder, let's see, this hyperbola rather will have its vertices on the y-axis. So notice when x is 0, you have y squared is 1, so y is plus or minus 1, okay? So there is your 1, there's your negative 1 on the other side, okay? Now this is just, yeah, I hope you still remember how to graph your hyperbola. So we can also label 1 and negative 1 on the x-axis, although of course we won't hit those, okay? But they're just useful for us later on for graphing our asymptotes, right? Okay, and getting your hyperbola. So one branch of the hyperbola, let me use another color here. So one branch of the hyperbola will start here. So starts at 0, 1, okay? Z is 0, okay? So you have that. And then there's another one going in the back, okay? And then on the other side, you have same story, right? So you have this and that, okay? So hopefully you see this is flat on the floor, the xy. Again, because z is missing, okay, that means to say we draw our rulings parallel to the z-axis. So that means to say no matter where we are, up or down, the relationship y squared minus x squared is always what's going to happen, okay? So that you can show by drawing this from here, extending it up parallel to the z-axis. This one, extend this up parallel to the z-axis. Again, if you want, you can draw, let's say, somewhere here, your y-axis again and kind of mimic this. Draw another branch like this that goes like that, all right? So there is your thing that you see here. And then for this guy in the back, maybe we can make it go out like this and draw that branch out there that we now see. And there's your half branch of the hyperbolic cylinder. Again, this will go indefinitely up as well as indefinitely down, okay? So that's one branch. And then on the other side, you'll have the same story. Extend this infinitely up or down, okay? Over here where you had your vertex, you go make this go up or down parallel to the z-axis, okay? And then there was another branch here. You can extend it also up or down parallel to the z. You can repeat this part of the hyperbola here, okay? All right, and then you'll have that other branch there. And you have your hyperbolic cylinder, okay? So this is the hyperbolic cylinder y squared minus x squared equals 1. So I won't do this anymore, but if you interchange the rows, let's say this is plus and that's minus, right? Then your hyperbola will just be here, going like this and in the back. And then you just draw your rulings parallel to the z-axis. So you'll have hyperbolas that are opening towards you and the other branches opening in the back, okay? So I hope that's enough illustration of how to do your hyperbolic cylinder. Have y squared over 4 minus z squared, let's say, is equal to 1. So hopefully you recognize that this is a hyperbola on the yz plane, okay? So let's try that. So we'll have, when z is 0, y squared is equal to 4, so y will be plus or minus 2. So we'll have 2 here and 2 on the other side in the back of the room. Okay, x is not present. Okay, then we'll have z. We just need the 1. So we need a 1 to draw our asymptotes, okay, on the z-axis, z is plus or minus 1. So just to remind you how to draw your hyperbola. So you need your asymptotes here, here, right, and so on and so forth. So let's see. Our vertices are on the y, so I have something like this and another one in the under, right, okay? And same thing here, I have this and another one under, Okay, so this hyperbola is flat on the yz plane, so on my board, okay? Since x is not present, that means to say I can draw my rulings parallel to the x, so this relationship is what I will hold no matter whether I'm in front here, anywhere I am here, or anywhere I am in the back, right? The relationship between y and z is given by this relationship, okay? So how do I do that? Again, let me try. So that means to say I have to draw my rulings parallel to the x. Does that look parallel? So over here I have something parallel to the x. Another one, something parallel to the x. And over there where I started the vertex, I have something parallel to the x, okay? If you want, we can draw our yz again and just copy this, okay, here. So I have that. And then copy that other branch up there, okay? So hopefully you see what I'm doing here. So you'll have this is on top of the floor, so we can see this, and this guy is really under, okay? So you'll have this opening sideways like this, okay? So there is your one branch. And likewise, the other branch, you will do the same thing. So just do this parallel to the x, parallel to the x, parallel to the x, and you'll have something like that, okay? So, yeah, sorry, I cheated over here, okay? But you have that other branch that's opening like this, okay? So that's your, another example of your hyperbolic cylinder.